The first number today is 22. That's the number of Arab nations who are members of the Arab League. And yesterday, the organization announced that it was going to form a de facto Arab army to send to hot zones across the Middle East, and a latest sign that the region continues to descend into chaos. Now, the Arab League is made up of some of the biggest players in the Middle East, but one of the biggest players, principally Iran, is not a member, and that's because Iranians are actually Persians and not Arab. But there's growing concern across the Arab world that Iranians have growing influence in traditional Arab areas and countries such as Syria, Iraq, and Yemen. As a matter of fact, Yemen has descended into civil war, and another member of the Arab League, Saudi Arabia, has started to launch a bombing campaign against Yemeni rebels. I feel like I need to have a graphic of Call of Duty above my shoulder during this entire segment. Now, Americans may cheer the fact that at least it won't be Americans that are going to these hot zones, but history shows that throwing more armed force at already existing armed conflict in the Middle East only enlarges the problem and exacerbates the issues already at work. And so, for the foreseeable future, the Middle East is going to remain everybody's problem.